me through for like 2 minutes. Now I'm clutching my lips. I'm going to move to my lips. To my right, I'm moving to my right.
Martin New, ASU reporting the final day complication. Another crack one. ASU playing imagination video. Before the show starts, behind the scenes. Report number, whatever this is. Stay tuned.
total of 6 children. All are success stories within their own right. 2 medical doctors, a principal, a mathematician, a musician, and then there's Donna. An entrepreneur, a leader, a lawyer, a businessman of international status, looking for a miracle, blossomed into life at Howard University, but then moved away from there by God's grace, with an NAACP scholarship to the University of Alabama, where it placed him in the second class, the 7th group of integrated law students for that university. He made his story. His story was on its way. This young man, after graduation, worked with the civil rights leader, activist, and lawyer, Fred Gray. And before long, in 1979, he decided to start his own law practice, looking for a miracle. And before long, he found himself convincing Governor Wallace, as an attorney, to pardon the last of the Scottsbury boys, Mr. Norris. He found himself...
anything that was going on campus, because the forces that opposed our growth did not want us to have any resources and went out of their way to make sure that we did not have any resources. And in those days, the old state superintendent of education and the governor ran the school. And I have watched it, yeah. You know, I remember my father Trump went down to there, you know, time to get the budget, you know, you work up the budget and go down there, trying to see what they're gonna give you to work with the next year, right? They stood them out there in the hall, right outside the governor's office. And they made them wait, Morrison, his predecessor up at A&M, they made them wait until the prison system was taken care of, until they funded the place to house and train the rapists, the murderers, the robbers, the dope dealers. After they took care of the prisons, and that day, you know, you had a dual prison system too. After they took care of both white and black prisoners, then your college president, the Alabama state president, the A&M president could come in, and whatever was left over was what your appropriation was. So to have that firsthand feel and knowledge of what they went through, those brave souls went through, and to come today, 2013. February 8th, 2013.
Thank you. I now invite Ms. Danielle Kennedy, Vice President of University Relations and Founders Day Coordinating Chair, to the podium to describe the awards that will be given today.
Today we are proud to continue a tradition, the presentation of awards. This year we will present 2 awards to honor ASU alumni whose contributions have helped to advance the cause of excellence at Alabama State University. The recipients were chosen after a nationwide search for nominees. The first award that will be given is the Spirit of Marion Award. The award recognizes individuals whose professional efforts